used as a food additive in nutritionally insignificant quantities to enhance the flavor or color or shelf life of the product. In the kitchen, we are using various spices and condiments. So, what is the difference? In the kitchen, the spices are distinguished from the fresh flavoring herbs. The spices are dried and often ground into powder for use, whereas condiments are those which are especially utilized when they are fresh, or they are just added for the garnishing purpose. So now you can give me quick examples of what are spices and condiments. When we talk about nutmeg and mace, clove, cardamom, saffron. So what do you think? What are the spices and condiments? Let us take the look at these four different types of plants which are used in our household as spices and condiments, but at the same time, they are having tremendous economic value. So, in this particular chapter, we are going to talk about all these economically important plants. Not only they are part and parcel of our food, but at the same time, they are commercially exploited. Our first, as I said, what is the basic difference between spices and condiments? Spices are usually dried and ground into a powder. Best example, chili. Chili is a spice. So, chili fruits are basically dried. They are ground into powder. Of course, we can also use chilies raw as it is. But then, basically, as a spice, it is dried and ground into a powder, chili powder. Then we have turmeric powder and so many different types of spices we are using at home. What about condiments? As I said, they are usually used fresh, sometimes dried, and they are used as a garnishing or seasoning purpose. Say, for example, when you are using dry fruits, these dry fruits are used in minimal quantities and they are used for the garnishing purpose on the sweets which you are making. Spices are dried seeds, root, bark, or other vegetable matters which are used to add flavor and color to the dish, whereas condiments are added to a dish to add or to complement its flavor. So they are enhancing the flavor by adding the condiments. That is a basic difference between spices and condiments. I'm sure you have seen these fruits in your home. नटमेग एंड मेस, हिंदी में इसके बोलते हैं जायफल, हिंदी या मराठी में जायफल एंड जायपत्री. आर यू अवेयर ऑफ दिस? यस. सो नटमेग इज अ जायफल व्हिच इज सीन इन दिस डायग्राम. यू कैन सी हियर, this is nutmeg is nothing but the seed which is seen in the middle, and around this particular seed there is a mace which is actually aril. Aril, I'll come to this part later on. So that aril is also economically important and that is called as a mace, जिसको हिंदी में बोलते हैं जायपत्री. सो जायफल और जायपत्री, these are coming from the same plant. They are two distinctly different spices which are produced from a single fruit of the plant by name Myristica fragrans. Myristica fragrans. which belongs to family Myristicaceae. You can see the fruit. The person is holding the fruit, and you can see the red color, bright red colored maize, and inside there is a presence of a seed. So both base as well as nutmeg are together. This is a tree of nutmeg. I have already told you the scientific name of the plant, Myristica fragrans. Fragrans, as the name suggests, it has got a typical fragrance. The family is Myristicaceae. How is the plant? The plant is an evergreen aromatic tree, which is about 9 to 12 meter in height. And from this particular plant, the fruits are collected, and from the fruits, two things are separated. One is a maize, which is a dried reticulate aril of the nutmeg, and second is the seed of nutmeg. When the fruit of nutmeg bursts open, an attractive bright scarlet maize is exposed. This maize is closely enveloped in a hard, thin, black shining shell of the seed called as nutmeg. The maize is skillfully removed, gently pressed flat, dried, and is called as typical blade of maize because it is thin like a blade. After drying, the maize becomes brittle and its original scarlet color changes to yellowish or reddish brown. The aroma and the flavor of maize is similar to that of nutmeg but is more refined. Maize is much more expensive than the nutmeg. So I was talking about aril. What is aril? I have already mentioned in the bracket, maize is a aril, which means it is a third seed coat. You are aware of in the seed, there is an outer covering, seed coat, and usually this seed coat has got two layers. The outermost is called as a testa, and the inner is called as tegmen. Testa and tegmen. But here there is one additional third seed coat, and that is referred to as aril. And this aril, in case of nutmeg, is referred to as mess. And this mess, which is also referred to as blade of mess, after drying becomes yellowish or reddish brown and brittle in the appearance. So, what are the properties and how this particular plant is used? You must have seen at home that this mace is being used while preparation of the spices. In making of the spices, there are so many things are added. जो घर में मसाले बनाते हैं हम लोग फॉर वेरियस पर्पस सो उनमें वॉट वी आर एडिंग आर सो मेनी थिंग्स वी आर एडिंग यू नेम इट एंड इट इज देयर देर आर चिलीज देर इज सौंफ फिनेल देन देर इज मस्टर्ड देन देर इज लाइकेन देन देर इज धनिया सो मेनी डिफरेंट वराइटी ऑफ एंड ऑफकोर्स द कॉम्पोजिशन चेंजेस एज पर योर रिक्वायरमेंट्स आर डिफरेंट सो इंडिया इज सच अ डाइवर्स कंट्री विथ इन टर्म्स ऑफ द पीपल हु आर लिविंग एवरी वन हैज गॉट अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ अ टेस्ट सो एवरी वन हैज गॉट अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ मसालेज स्पाइसेस विच दे आर यूजिंग एंड दैट्स वाई द कॉम्पोजिशन चेंजेस सो एज पर रिक्वायरमेंट वी एड दीज पर्टिकुलर मटीरियल्स एंड ऑफकोर्स दे एनहांसेस द फ्लेवर As far as the basic properties of nutmeg and the oil which is extracted from nutmeg and that of mace, they have got some common properties. First of all, they have a very sharp, spicy aroma. The oil which is extracted, they have a very sharp spicy aroma, and they have got number of therapeutic properties. Therapeutic in the sense they are used for various treatments, and they have number of you can say applications for the same. So the first therapeutic property of nutmeg is written as analgesic. In simple words, analgesic means the sort of healing property, wound healing, or you can say analgesic is also something called as painkiller activities. Every now and then we take painkiller if you have any problem, but then it is the property which is present in many of the herbs which we are using as spices and condiments. So nutmeg is one such example that the oil has got sharp spicy aroma. It is analgesic. It is anti-rheumatic. Rheumatism is nothing but the joint pains. So especially with old age, in Ayurveda, it is written as the Vata, Pitta and Kapha. These are the three dosha in our body. If there is an imbalance between these three dosha, we get a particular disease. Rheumatism, jisko Hindi mein sandhivat aisa bolte hai, it is basically the joint pains, and it is due to elevation, increase of Vata in our body. So especially the old age people, during winter, they have got lot of joint pains. So usually we do the massage with the oil. It's better to do massage, and it relieves that kind of a pain. So that anti-rheumatic kind of a property is present in the oil of this particular plant, that is nutmeg and mace. Then antiseptic, it do not allow the septic to happen. That is, it will kill the microorganisms. Antispasmodic, spasm, due to contraction and relaxation continuous, the muscles may sprain. There might be spasm. Internally also our muscles may get spasm. So this oil relieves those particular spasm. Carminative is nothing but relieving gases from your body. Now releasing gases from the body can happen two ways, either from the mouth or from the anus. If it is happening from the mouth, it is carminative. If it is happening via anus, along with the stool, passing of the stool, then it is called as laxative, which is the next property. It is also digestive. It helps in the process of digestion. Parturient is the one who causes parturition. And frankly speaking, parturition is nothing but the child delivery. So excess of this myristica can be dangerous, especially, in fact, it should be avoided and should not be given to the carrying ladies, because it can cause the parturition, and that can be very dangerous. It also acts as a stimulant and tonic. These are the basic properties which are attributed to the plant called as nutmeg or mace. Now, all these properties are obviously because of the various chemical constituents. The spicy aroma is only due to the presence of essential oils, the secondary metabolites present in the plant, like essential oils. I'm sure you have heard about secondary metabolites. There are two types of metabolites in the plants, primary and secondary. Primary, like carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, they are essential for the growth and development of plants. And there are some metabolites which are not required for the growth and development, but for some other reason. Now that other reason consists of either attraction for the pollinators or seed dispersal, or maybe for defense purpose. So maybe because of the strong smell of the essential oil, many of the insect pests, they are inhibited. So what are different secondary metabolites we are aware of? Number one, alkaloids. I'm sure many of you are aware of. Neem is the best example, which has got variety of alkaloids, and due to that, any kind of a pest do not attack this plant. Then second example, essential oils. Then we have glycosides, we have tannins. So many variety of different secondary metabolites are seen, and they are responsible for various characteristics. So here in this particular plant, nutmeg, the aroma of the nutmeg oil is mainly because of the essential oils. And in this particular oil, there are variety of constituents which are giving that specific aroma as well as specific characteristics, like camphene, pinene, limonene, borneol, terpineol, geraniol, safrol, and myristicin. And it is this myristicin which is a major one, which is in highest concentration. And that's the reason why the name of the plant is Myristica, Myristica fragrans. The name has been derived from the same myristicin. So now we are aware of the various properties. Then we are aware of the chemical constituents. So now let us talk about the various uses of Myristica. Number one, nutmeg and mace are used mainly as baking spices in sweet delicacies. The sweets which are made, in those sweets, little bit of Myristica is added. And in fact, many times we feel drowsy after eating the kind of sweets during the festival season for the same reason. If someone has got a problem of sleeping, the best medicine available is milk, warm milk, and in that little bit of this Myristica is added. The person would sleep. So nutmeg and mace, they should be used in little quantities. If you are adding too much of them, 100% the people will sleep after eating it. So nutmeg and mace are mainly used for baking spices.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
As you said, ki if everyone facing the problem of less sleeping, then he should use this. But if he or she is facing the problem of more sleeplessly, like every day she or he is facing laziness or anything like that, so what should he or she will do?
See, first of all, you have to find out what is the reason. What is the reason why you are not getting proper sleep? Generally, the mothers would give Myristica to their the babies, especially babies, along with the milk, so that they can properly sleep. Because bachpan aisa hota hai ki jisme thoda achha neend hona chahiye. It is good for growth and development. But then they won't continue it for longer period of time. Because if they continue for longer period of time, then you can understand what would happen. Yeah. As far as over sleeping is concerned, you have to find out what is the actual reason. It may be because of some kind of a nervous problem as well. Okay. That drowsiness may last because of many of the medicines also. And that is the reason why, first of all, you'll have to find out what is the reason. Many of the tonics, including cough syrups, they can also cause a drowsiness. So overuse of any kind of such a substances should be first of all prevented. Yeah, even if you are not sleeping properly, it is mainly because of the stress condition. If there is a too much of stress, there is a hormonal imbalance. So the sleep inducing hormones like that of melatonin, serotonin, these kind of hormones need to be stimulated. Warm milk, only pure warm milk, is also enough sometimes. And you have to see to it that at least for half an hour or 1 hour, you are not coming in contact with TV, mobile, anything. And at least before going to sleep, at least one and a half hour before, you must have completed your dinner. If you take care of such things, then getting a good sleep is not a problem. But I'll tell you, especially of this generation, the problem is not getting sleep. The problem is oversleep, because we have disturbed our natural cycle. Our natural cycle is we sleep in the night and we are awakened in the daytime. But what has happened because of the internet, Netflix, web series, I'm not talking about studies at all. Because if at all anyone studies, they will not study late night. So late night, it is mainly because of mobile and technology. And then in the morning, people are not getting to the colleges in time for the same reason. And even nowadays, since you are attending the lectures, practicals, everyone feels ki I'm just logged in, so my attendance is done. So that is not the case. So it is oversleeping. Normally 6 to 7 hours of sleep is enough. Whatever extra you are taking is laziness. I hope I have answered your query. Hello.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So baking spices in sweet delicacies, we are adding myristica. They are also used in flavoring curries, gravies, pickles, ketchup, sauces, and spice mixtures, which we are preparing. Nutmeg and mace are also used as a carminative. We have already mentioned carminative, releasing gases. Fennel, sauf, is also used for the same. Then as an astringent agent will have a very, you know, typical test. They will have astringency. Aphrodisiac is actually, if you go term wise, it literally means the sex tonic. So there are some medicines in which Ayurvedic or Yunani medicines in which myristica is being used as an aphrodisiac. Of course, not alone, along with different combinations and stimulating agent. They are also used in pharmaceutical preparations for dysentery. Dysentery is nothing but loose motions, but obviously not for dysentery. It is to stop dysentery. So it is anti-dysentery. Then it is also used as a medicine for stomachache. That is, if you have stomach problem. Flatulence is nothing but if you have gases problem. So release of gases is called flatulence. Nausea, vomiting, malaria, rheumatism, sprains, sciatica. Sciatica is nothing but the lower back problem, especially by continuous sitting, especially in the wrong position in the chair, we get lower back pain, and that is called sciatica. Even paralysis and leprosy, these are the cases where myristica is used. Now, many times it happens that I write down all these uses, and then people think of like using these plants as it is for any of the ailments which they themselves or their family members. So here I would like to ask you all, see, these are the suggestive uses, but then everyone's prakruti is different. And the prakruti has to be first of all diagnosed. And based on that diagnosis by the expert, that is doctor, a particular combination of a drug is provided. So when I say myristica is used for these problems, that doesn't mean that you will start from tomorrow or today itself giving the myristica to that particular person. No, I will never suggest it. First of all, you get it diagnosed. See, it has happened because of the invention of Google. Everyone is trying to be a doctor. It is not like that. Let me tell you that everything is not given 100% correct on Google or even Wikipedia. Wikipedia, you can write n number of things, they will publish. They are not there to verify it. So it is just like you and me. Anyone can write anything in the Google and it will show it as a result only. So please don't do that. There are people who have studied medicine. They are definitely much better than our medicine. And let them first of all diagnose and suggest you a specific. But yes, why I'm telling you this is that we are using myristica since generations for making of spices or as a condiment, and knowingly and unknowingly we are getting the benefits for the simple reason we are using them in comparatively small quantities. So before giving it as a medicine alone, we should first of all take a proper diagnosis. Adding that into food is not going to make any difference. But then hum log khane mein utna hi dalte hain jitna uska swad hai. So namak swad anusar, ye kyun bolte hain hum log? Because utna hi dalna chahiye jisse swad rahega. You cannot add too much of myristica in the kind of a plate of dish which you are preparing. It will spoil the dish. It will spoil the complete fragrance, aroma of that particular dish. And that's the reason why you have to be very, very careful. Okay? So this is all about the first plant. The first plant is myristica fragrans, which belongs to family Myristicaceae. And we have mentioned there are two important parts in this particular plant. One is the seed itself, which is called nutmeg. And second is the mace, which is covering the seed. What is a mace? Mace is nothing but aril. What is an aril? Aril is nothing but the third seed coat. Okay, usually there are only two, testa and tegmen. This is an additional, which is called as aril. And this aril is bright red in color. Later on, it turns out to be yellowish in color. This is a fruit of myristica fragrans. See, afterward, when you purchase it in the market, it looks like this. So myristica fragrans is the plant we discussed today. The second plant which now we are going to discuss is clove. I'm sure everyone knows clove. Clove ko kya bolte hai Hindi mein aap?
Long.
Long. Yes, long. It is long. Sabne long dekha hai. So which part of the plant it is? Are you aware of? जैसे हमने बोला कि जायफल एंड जायपत्री, दीज आर द प्लांट पार्ट्स, सीड एंड एक्स्ट्रा सीड कोट. सो सिमिलरली क्लव इज बेसिकली अ प्लांट विच इज नेटिव टू इंडोनेशिया. इट इज नॉट एन इंडियन प्लांट, इट इज फ्रॉम इंडोनेशिया एंड इट इज यूज्ड एज अ स्पाइस in cuisines all over the world. So when you are making the spices, we are also adding clove to it. The term clove is actually derived from a French word, clove, meaning nail, nail. Due to its similarity with that of a broad-headed nail, I'm not talking about nail of your finger. I'm talking about a nail and hammer, जो कारपेंट्री के काम आता है ना, नेल, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट. ओके, सो इट इज अ ब्रॉड हेडेड नेल. द क्लब ऑफ कॉमर्स, कॉमर्स इन द सेंस इकोनॉमिकली जो यूज करते हैं, इट इज बेसिकली द एयर ड्राइड अनओपन्ड फ्लावर बड ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम अ प्लांट साइजीजियम एरोमेटिकम, विच इज ऑल्सो सिनोनिमस विथ यूजेनिया कैरोफाइलेटा फ्रॉम द फैमिली Myrtaceae. Myrtaceae is a family from which we have one more plant, and you are aware of that plant. It is called eucalyptus. Eucalyptus, जिसको हम हिंदी में बोलते हैं नीलगिरी. You remember that typical smell of नीलगिरी? Similar kind of a smell, but bit different, थोड़ा सा different, and that you get from clove also. And it is because of the again essential oils which are present in the plant. This is a clove plant. I'm sure you have not seen the plant before because this plant is not very common in our area. It is from Indonesia. So clove is not cultivated in, at least in Mumbai region. The plant is a very handsome, medium-sized evergreen tree with a straight trunk about 8 to 12 meters. The unopened flower buds are green in color. You can make out over here. These are the ideal. See, this flower has opened. So this is not ideal now. So it will be allowed to make the fruit. Okay. And then the seeds will be collected for sowing. But then commercially, what we are interested are these particular flower buds, which are unopened. The plant bears large lanceolate leaves and sanguine flowers in numerous groups of terminal clusters. The flower buds are at first of the pale color and gradually becomes green, after which they develop into bright red color. You can see here the bright red colored flowers. When they are ready for collecting, cloves are harvested when 1.5 to 2 centimeter long and consists of a long calyx terminating in four spreading sepals and four unopened petals, which form a small ball in the center. So if I take out a single clove, unopened flower, I can see these are the sepals. In fact, this is a calyx tube. These are the petals at the top. Androecium and gynoecium are not seen. After drying, these buds turn dark brown and yields the clove of commerce. The clove which are commercially used, they are dark brown in color. And for these plants, clove, we have to find out their properties and their chemical constituents. Look at this. Now, these are the dried clove buds. This is longitudinal section of the clove, and in this longitudinal section, you can see this is unopened. So this is corolla from the exterior. Inside you can see anther, the stamens, the styles. This is the calyx from either side.
देखो इधर डायग्राम के ऊपर लिखा है मैम कलर का
हेलो हेलो
वो बोलो तो
हेलो
अपन खाते ना वो कैरन मनाने का
जावेद Now this is the stalk of this flower, that is hypanthium, and all over this hypanthium you can see presence of oil glands. These are the dotted glands which are referred to as oil glands, in which this essential oil is present, and it is the same oil which is having various chemical properties. So let us find out what are the chemical properties. Clove is basically aromatic flavoring agent having stimulating, it stimulates antimicrobial properties, antimicrobial, so it is killing the microorganisms. Clove oil is colorless to pale yellow with a medium to watery viscosity, and it has a warm, strong, spicy smell. If you go to the medical store, clove oil separately is available. Especially, it is given for oral care, dental care, especially for dentist. Clove oil is one of the medicine which is available. Even at night, if you have a tremendous pain in your teeth, one of the best medicine which is in front of you in the kitchen, and that is nothing but again clove. So you just have to take the clove bud, put it in the region where it is paining, just chew it, and then you will feel the pain is comparatively lesser. It will not go immediately, but yes, some relief you will definitely get. So these are the properties of clove oil. Now these properties are due to certain chemicals. You can see here the clove oil bottle is kept. Look at the color. It is very pale yellow, and it has got a very strong and spicy smell. As far as the chemical constituents are concerned, the strong aroma and flavor of the clove is due to the presence of essential oil. The main chemical components of clove oil are eugenol, eugenol acetate, isoeugenol, and carophyllene. These are very important constituents. These constituents are also present in the other plants belonging to same family, that is Myrtaceae. I have already given you one of the member, Nilgiri, Eucalyptus. In Myrtaceae, there are so many other medicinally important plants available, and they also shows presence of these chemical constituents. But of course, the concentration is different. So what are the uses? There are various uses of the clove oil. First of all, it is used as a culinary spice, as the flavoring blends well with both sweet and savory dishes. I'm sure you must have added the clove in various kind of dishes which are prepared, spicy dishes. The clove can also be used as it is. Okay. I think even in biryanis also, we are putting some of the spices as it is. Jisko hum bolte khada masala, yani ke pure masale as it is. So elaichi is one, then long is there, then dalchini is there. So all these kind of spices are used as it is without, being converted into powder or something like that. Clove is used for flavoring curries, gravies, in pickles, ketchup, sauces, and the spice mixtures which we are making. It is highly valued in medicines as carminative. Carminative is releasing gases, aromatic and stimulant. It is also used in flatulence if you have gases problem, and dyspepsia. Dyspepsia is the inability to digest properly, indigestion you can say. It is also being added, it is also helping in the process of digestion and toothache. For toothache, this many of the toothpaste also are taking clove as one of the very important ingredient. It is also ingredient in various industrial products like perfumes, soaps, toothpaste, mouthwashes, and pharmaceutical operations because of these oils, essential oils, which are present in the clove. So in this particular lecture, we have had discussion on two different plants which are used as spices and condiment. Number one, Myristica fragrans, which is giving you a product called as nutmeg as a seed and mace as an aril, the third seed coat, which belongs to family Myristicaceae. And the second plant we discussed today is clove, which is scientifically known as Syzygium aromaticum, or also known as Eugenia carophyllata, which belongs to the family Myristicaceae. Okay. There are two more plants for the discussion in this chapter. One is cardamom, that is elaichi, and second is saffron, which is nothing but
Kesar.
Okay. So in the next lecture, we shall be discussing about these two plants. Let me